एच टू मॉलिक्यूल। एच टू मॉलिक्यूल इज मेड अप ऑफ टू हाइड्रोजन एटम्स, लेट अस राइट डाउन देयर कॉन्फिगरेशन। इट इज 1s1 एंड देयर विल बी सेकेंड हाइड्रोजन एटम, इट्स कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑल्सो बी 1s1। बट कीप वन थिंग इन योर माइंड दैट वी विल शो द ऑपोजिट स्पिन ऑफ द टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। नाउ हियर इज द axis that shows increasing energy from bottom to top. Here is the hydrogen atom with its 1s1 atomic orbital. Now we will not show the shapes of the orbitals. We can show the orbitals in the form of boxes. Here will be the second hydrogen atom. You will keep them at equal position with respect to energy. That is also 1s atomic orbitals. When they will overlap, they will form two molecular orbitals, in one in the low energy and second in the high energy. Because s always show the end-to-end overlap, so it will be sigma 1s bonding molecular orbital, and this one will be sigma star 1s anti-bonding molecular orbital. According to a Fock principle, the electrons will be filled first in the low energy. So both electrons with the opposite spin, they will be filled in this low energy bonding molecular orbital, while antibonding molecular orbital will remain empty. Now, after this overlap, we can say that in case of H2 molecule, now its electronic configuration is sigma 1s2. Because the sigma star 1s is empty, so it is sigma 1s2. We can also calculate a very important concept here, that is the bond order. Actually, bond order is equal to the number of electrons in bonding molecular orbital minus number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbitals divided by 2. Or you can say, the number of electrons, half of the number of electrons, or the half of the difference of the electrons in bonding molecular orbitals and antibonding molecular orbitals. Let us calculate the bond order of the hydrogen. In this case, the bond order is equal to the number of electrons in bonding molecular orbital is 2. Minus 0, because this one is empty, divided by 2. So the answer will be 1. The bond order of hydrogen is 1. It simply means that between two hydrogen atoms, there will be a single bond. And to calculate this bond order is very important, because this bond order will provide information about the bond energy, also about the bond length, and some other criteria that will also be defined on the basis of the bond order. Now let us discuss whether this hydrogen is paramagnetic or diamagnetic. You can see that this bonding molecular orbital is doubly filled. There is no electron here. So all the electron in H2 molecule, they will be paired. And when all the electrons are paired, magnet repels such species. So hydrogen is diamagnetic. Hydrogen is diamagnetic. Now let us discuss another very simple molecule. That is, now instead of hydrogen, let us talk about the helium, He2. And you know the helium is 2-4. So its electronic configuration should be 1s2. Similarly, the other helium atom is also 2, 4, and its electronic density will be 1s, 2. Here we will also say that it is helium 2, 4, and this atom is also helium 2, 4. Here is pair of electron, and here is also pair of electron. Now total electrons are 4. 2 will be filled in the sigma bonding molecule or orbital, and the other 2 will be filled in the sigma star 1s antibonding molecule or orbital. Now let us calculate the bond order for the helium. In case of helium, the number of electron in bonding molecule or orbital are 2, and the number of electron in antibonding molecule or orbital, that is also equal to 2. So 2, that should be equal to 0. What does it mean? It simply means that He2 cannot exist, because in between two helium atoms there will be no bond. So He in the diatomic form, helium, cannot exist. This theory has this advantage that it explains the non-existence of the noble gases in the diatomic form. It proves that the noble gases must be present in their atomic form. They cannot exist in the diatomic molecular form.